establish consciousness for it and like make a difference. And so using the platform of filmmaking to do that is to me ideal. And so now there is a double-edged sword with that, because the entertainment industry is not necessarily set up to enlighten everybody, even though in a way it does somehow, you know, push the culture forward and like change things, and little differences are made here and there. But the media industry is kind of controlled by these special interest groups and large corporations.
So you're making a movie.
Yeah, so we're making a show that's about the monetary system.
Oh, it's going to be a show, like a series.
A series, yeah. We're living in a time where no longer do studios have an embargo on like what gets showcased to the public. And I can tell you, Netflix, Hulu, Amazon, they have so much money because they're subscriber based. And so you have a whole unit of people who are paying, you know, a lot of people paying like $9.99, you know, they're making billions of dollars, you know, they have a crap ton of money, even more money than some of the studios. You won't know that, but they do.
Yeah, and like YouTube too.
Exactly, YouTube as well. And so what it is they're their own financiers and distributors, so it cuts out like a lot of the politics of filmmaking and all that. So, and then with series, you can tell like a story that's much more rich and deeper, because you have like a 10-hour block as opposed to like an hour and a half, 2 hours, because the whole season for a series is like, you know, 45 minutes an episode, 45 minutes to an hour. So you ultimately end up getting to tell a story, you know, 10-hour long story, as opposed to just, anyway, that's what attracted me to it. And I got lucky enough to meet a guy who believed in a lot of what I had been working on for some years now, and decided to partner up with me and to create original content for Netflix. And he actually had success with Netflix previous to meeting with me, because he owned IP, intellectual property, to some previous written work or whatever. But he was an executive producer for like Batman versus Superman, 300, a lot of comic books. So anyway, so this show that we have in development now is kind of about the banking system and monetary system. So I have a little team of people right now writing this show, but we are in a position where we're creating a proof of concept, and then that's what will get us the full show.
You said proof of concept.
Yeah.
You know a little something, don't you?
I know some stuff. But in the meantime, that's why I'm like driving a Lyft, because I stopped working so that I could, well, I stopped freelancing so that I could. I'm saying that we're here.
Awesome.
Oh, great.
We'll have to get our nails done and pay in Bitcoin.
So that's interesting, because I had a friend that was able to do it, and it worked out well for her for a while anyways. But so what did they change exactly as far as how you were able to lease it? This, it's in LA, right? I mean, this is, you're a local?
Yeah, no, I was able to lease it just fine.
That's cool.
It's just, I can't, once you're in that program, once you're in the Uber Vehicle Solutions program, you can't cash out daily.
Uber Vehicle Solutions program, but you can't cash out daily after that.
Right, because they hold on to your, to the money and to make sure that they're able to get their payment.
So Lyft allows you to get paid every day?
Yeah, I'm not sure. You know, I don't know if Uber, if Lyft has a leasing program, but yeah, I was able to get, like, if I didn't lease this car, I'd still be getting cashed out every day with Uber. But yeah, and Lyft has the same thing. It always has.
Very. Do you like driving? Have you met any interesting people?
I like driving. The